And one of our delivery channels interacts with Office Communications Server. That's basically communicator, Windows communicator. So if you're using OCS within your organization, you can have, you know, one of these nice little alerts show up via the communicator. So and you can have multiple show up at once. If you've got three notifications, you'll stack up three different conversations at once. It's really fairly robust. So let's take a look at how this actually works or how this is configured. The first thing you're going to have to do is download this Office Communications Server plugin from our tech support site. It's not part of the standard install, but download it from our tech support site and then run that installation, and you should see that you've got a new delivery channel. Let me show you that again. I'm in Tools. This is under the Notifications section. Tools, Notification Settings. And if I go into Delivery Channels, you can see all of the current plugins. Now, these are the two that ship with the system. This is the one we just downloaded and installed. And you do have to configure it for, you know, communicating with your Office Communications Server. So if you're not the guy, you know, really familiar with all that, get them involved at this point. You'll find more information about this on the, it's a separate document. It's not in the regular notifications document, but you'll get this with the download. It's the Delivery Channel User Guide for OCS. So use that as a reference to figure out how you're going to configure this. And that's obviously something you only need to do once. Now, I want to point out a couple of different things that are taking place with this OCS plugin here. First of all, the users who are actually going to receive, you know, these communications down here, they don't have to install anything. They're just going to have to be running Communicator. And we do have an application that we install called the Office Communications Server, the OCS Relay Service, that maintains the communications with Office Communications Server, with the Microsoft component. That maintains that connection. And then this plugin here, the one we just saw, this is what communicates with that OCS Relay Service. So it's doing that via web services. So that's sending information to that other application, which in turn is communicating with Office Communications Server. Now, once you've made sure you've configured this properly and you've installed the plugin, now it's time to create a delivery endpoint. Typically, we're going to be doing this with contacts, Active Directory contacts, because they typically have communicator accounts. And so I'll give you an example. I'll go out and I'll do a search for, this is one of the users we've been using all during this exercise here. It's a Solution B. Smith, that's an Active Directory user. What I'd like to do is add a new delivery channel for that user. So this is going to go, instead of to his email, it's going to go to Communicator, his instance of Communicator. Now the system is smart enough to take a look at the presence status of this B. Smith, and if he's not there, you know, if he's busy or if he's unavailable, it won't send this. It'll basically just only send it if he's available. So let me go ahead and add a new delivery endpoint. This time the delivery endpoint is going to be this OCS. So I'll just say this is, we'll just call this B. Smith's via communicator. Now, as we have seen with all of our other notification, you know, mechanisms, there's a variety of choices as to, you know, exactly how this behaves. For example, do we send him a message both when it triggers and also when it closes? You can do that with this checkbox. Is there any kind of a retry interval? Is there a maximum number of those retries? The purpose of this is to simply give you some flexibility there. And of course, now you are required to put in an SIP address, typically the same as their email address. So, you know, I mean, technically it can be something different. That's typically what we see with Active Directory and Office Communicator. So this would be SIP solution underscore B. Smith at virtuallabs.in. That's his email address. Now, you can set the priority. And these are just simply picking up on the instant messaging priorities that we get from published from Microsoft. So those are the priorities you can choose. You can choose to limit the amount of conversations that can go on at once. force, probably enough anybody's going to need. But you know, if we do fire off four or five things via this notification delivery endpoint, you know, he could find himself with many conversations going on. You can just throttle that right there. And this toggles what format we send it in. And this also allows you to include one of those acknowledgement links. So if you recall, with our other notifications, we have the option to incorporate an acknowledgement into the email, for example. And we're giving that same option right here. Now, the rest of this is all just, you know, how you decide whether you're going to send notifications based on what their status is. Yeah, I mean, there's no reason to send it if he's not going to be available to receive it. Now, once I'm finished with that, I'll go ahead and check this in, and then I'll make use of it. So I'll go ahead and check this in. Okay, now that I've built that new delivery endpoint for B. Smith, I can make use of it by going into these notifications and adding him as a subscriber. Now, here's a list that hasn't been updated. I'm going to need to refresh this. Let me just go ahead and choose Refresh. As you can see, now we see the new delivery endpoint. I'll go ahead and drag this over. Now he's subscribed at this point. Now, just as we have seen before, you have control over what we send as a message. You've got control over what kind of content we send. You know, do we include the trigger? Do we include an instant RT web parts trend? Now, this in particular, the instant RT web parts trends, kind of interesting. That's going to give you full feature of, you know, a Pi web parts trend that's going to launch in a separate window from the communicator. Now, in addition to launching it into a separate window, you can also specify that you have a context pane that appears within communicator. Now, if you choose no link, then you'll simply just get a message. If you choose acknowledge, then this is one of the relatively newer features of communicator. It's got a little widget, or pane, I should say, that allows scripting. And so we can have a scriptable link that will allow you to do an acknowledge or an acknowledge with a comment. We also have support for a web part trend. So that would give you a trend within the communicator pane itself. That's going to be the context pane within communicator. So in this case, I think I'll go ahead and choose that. And once you've done that, just go ahead and check this in. And now we're ready to demonstrate it. Now, what you're going to see as an end result is going to be this. This is what the user is going to see on his screen in the bottom right-hand corner. It's just simply a communicator message. Now, when he opens that up, he's going to be opening this up to show the full message, and he'll be able to have this context pane that he can interact with. This is where he's going to see that, that Pi web parts trend or the acknowledgement option. I'm going to switch over to a video and you'll see what this looks like live. So as you can see, when this notification first comes up, because we chose a context pane, and that context pane is showing a Pi trend, then we can go ahead and interact with that. Now if I click on this instant RT web parts trend, this is going to go ahead and launch a separate window that is in fact the regular Pi web parts trend. And so of course it's got a lot more functionality. Now back on this page, you'll see we do have this acknowledge and acknowledge with comment. If you click there, that's going to go ahead and launch, again, a separate place for you to go ahead and do the acknowledgement. Now one minor point, you're going to notice Office Communication Server 2007 has some pretty steep requirements. You're going to have to get a 64-bit version of Windows, and that's the same for this OCS relay service.